electronic devices, please turn them off because it's very hard to hear in this room. If you have any conversations that you want to have personally, kind of take them outside until your case is heard. I'd like to introduce the members of our board, starting from left to right.
Jeff Cotone, member of the board.
Bill Harse, member of the board. Tom Fox, member of the board.
Phil Rubina, member of the board.
Steve Price, solicitor to the board.
Thank you.
Keith Zahner, zoning administrator.
Thank you. We have one other board member. Hopefully he'll be here, Mr. Barrs. He'll be here a little bit later. We have a number of cases before us this evening, and at the conclusion, we will make decisions on last month's meeting.
Here's Jared.
So to begin with, it's 146 West Oley Street, Appeal 2017-55. If the applicant is present, come up and have a seat, please. Okay, would you swear in our zoning officer, please?
Yes, I do.
Has notice for this appeal been given?
146 West Oley.
Oh, 146 West Oley.
146 West Oley, yeah.
Oh, we got the wrong one?
No, they got the wrong people.
See, I tried.
Okay.
That was the interpreter's fault because I thought the one was the other. So blame it on me. So don't let me put a Leo. But don't put that on the record.
All right, let's start this over again. You want to swear in our zoning officer? 146 West Oley Street, Appeal 2017-55. We'll just make sure we do it right. Okay, go ahead.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, and help you God?
Yes, I do.
Okay, has notice for this appeal been given?
Yes, it has.
All right, Mr. Price.
Thank you. I'll put some exhibits into the record. Exhibit number one is the notice. Exhibit number two is proof of publication of the notice. Exhibit number three is proof of posting of the notice. Exhibit number four is the application, including all of its attachments. And exhibit number five is the zoning ordinance of the City of Reading as amended.
Okay, thank you. Would you swear in our interpreter, and then we will swear in our applicant.
Do you swear to interpret the English to Spanish and the Spanish to English to the best of your abilities, and help you God?
Yes, I do. Thomas Gran, G-R-A-N, certified legal interpreter.
Okay, and...
Does he write yet? La derecha. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, and help you God?
Lo juro ante Dios.
Sí.
Yes. Yes, I swear to tell the truth.
Your name for the record?
Su nombre para que conste en el acta.
Nereida A. Rojas Guava.
Nereida A. Rojas Guava.
Okay. Okay. Muy bien. Would you ask our applicant just to tell us in her own words what she wants to do and why she wants to do this daycare?
¿Qué es lo que usted quiere hacer y por qué quiere hacer eso de guardería de ropa? Explícalos para ellos.
Yo quiero hacer, lograr tener un home care, un family care, que es para cuidar niños y para un mejor futuro para mí y para beneficio también de todos.
I'd like to do like a home care or daycare for children, and it can help to prove a better future both for the children and myself.
Okay.
No, okay.
All right. How does she intend to provide a play area and parking spaces and drop-off areas for the people who might use her facility?
Entonces, ¿qué idea tiene para un lugar para jugar, un lugar para estacionar y un lugar para dejar a los niños cuando las madres entran?
Sí, tengo.
Quizá uno por uno, quizá play.
Sí, tengo el playground, que es la yarda.
I have, first of all, with the play area, I have a playground in the yard. Y,
el
estacionamiento.
No tengo estacionamiento.
I don't have parking. ¿Y dónde dejarlo?
Ese, perdón.
¿Dónde van a dejar los madres?
La madre, los niños. Uh-huh. El daycare.
¿Y qué arreglo?
¿Perdón?
¿Tiene un arreglo específico?
Yo quería que le diera un parque, que se puede poner, que sea 10 mil
And as far as the drop-off area, I was hoping there was some way we could get a parking space marked off with a special parking, maybe 10 minutes limit, so mothers coming in could drop off their kids or pick them up as need be.
Okay. What is on either side of her property?
¿Qué está en cara de los dos lados de su propiedad? ¿Son casas o qué?
Son casas.
They are houses on both sides, ambos lados, no? Yeah, on both sides.
All right. Any other members of the board, do you have any questions? And we'll start from left to right.
I have none.
No?
An hour's operation.
I have a question. It says here that you want to have up to 12 children?
Dice aquí en la solicitud, usted quiere un máximo de 10 niños, ¿correcto? Yes, that's correct.
I have a question for Mr. Zaner. Is 12 children applicable for this type of situation?
No, from both the city's zoning ordinance perspective and the definition of what is a family daycare home, state licensing also categorizes the Department of Public Welfare, gives a limitation of a maximum of six.
Un límite de solo seis niños en un lugar como su clase de seis.
Would six be acceptable to her?
Si aprobamos el caso, sería aceptable seis. Yes, six would be acceptable.
And what are her hours of operation going to be?
Las horas de función de esa guardería.
Las horas.
Ajá.
Serían de 5 de la mañana.
Ajá.
A 10 de la noche porque hay dos de turno.
There would be, yeah, there would be from 5 in the morning to 10 at night. It would be two shifts of daycare.
Okay, thank you.
How many children does she have living with her?
Yeah, that's a good question. How many, does she have any children of her own living in that house, or are there other people living in that house with her?
¿Tiene sus propios niños que viven en su casa contigo, o otra persona que vive contigo en la casa?
No, es mía.
Una sola hija.
Una sola.
I have one daughter. I do have a son, but he's gone to college. He doesn't live with me any longer.
Okay, thank you.
Gracias.
Mr. Price, any questions?
None.
Mr. Zaner, any questions or comments at this point?
No.
Could I ask one question, Mr. Zaner? The fact that you said six children, now she's talking about possibly two shifts. Is it six max at any time, or what happens when the shifts are crossing?
It's six children being watched that aren't her own children, up to six, and as long as they're separate shifts, according to our ordinance, it can operate within the certain hours expressed in D1D between, to not be between 11 p.m. and 6 a.m. Now, Mr. Fox.
Another question for Mr. Zaner. Is the yard in the back, is there a drawing of that, and is that, the size of that yard, does that meet the criteria for the number of children involved?
We sought that input from the applicant, specifically zoning inspector Hoffman, and we were unsuccessful in getting that information. We were trying to get the backyard square footage, and or if she was going to opt for two parking spaces back there. When we posted the property a week ago, it was readily noticed when we drove around back the alley. The alley is on a very steep slope in comparison to her rear property line, and that it's not feasible to convert that into parking, so with unless through extraordinary grading measures and expense. So we were expecting to get feedback from her regarding the size of the rear yard, but we did not.
If the interpreter could inject a thought, the applicant has shown a little drawing with square footage 18 by 45, and she's calculated 810 square foot for the backyard, according to her calculations.
That was not part of our package, is that correct?
No se entregó eso como parte del paquete cuando usted hizo eso.
Is it?
Yeah.
Él tiene una copia.
Oh, okay. I didn't see it in my package. All right, thank you.
I do have a question, since he brought up the parking. Were you intending to have parking? You had a nice picture. This is the backyard. This is your backyard. Were you intending to have that for a parking area and for the playground?
Playground.
Okay, déme explicar. Entonces, esa parte en el patio trasero, eso es solo para jugar y nada para estacionar. It's just for a playground, nothing was going to be used for parking.
Where would the people park in the back? Is there?
There is none.
In and out? Okay, I don't know why that came up. Okay.
There is none.
All right, that's it. Thank you.
Now, does anybody in the audience have any questions of this applicant? Just a question, not whether you like the idea or you don't. Any question?
They're talking about their cases.
Okay. All right, seeing none. Is there anybody in the audience that would like to testify for the granting of the application? They would need to stand up, give us their name and address, and then say whether they're in favor of this or not, whether they're in favor of it, and then we'll find out if anybody is not in favor of it.
Hay alguien que quiere testificar a favor de este proyecto, si así tendrá que ponerse de pie y dar su nombre y dirección.
Okay, you want to come up, please? Okay, we need to swear him in and get his name and address.
You speak English or Spanish?
No.
Okay. Okay.
I'm sorry, are we using the interpreter?
Yes, he does. He is interpreter.
So I already swore you in. Raise your right hand. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, to help you God?
Yes, I swear.
Okay, your name for the record?
Su nombre?
Joe Edward Hero.
Joe?
John.
John?
J-I-R-O-N.
John A. Hero.
Okay, wait a second, I'm sorry. J-H-O-N-G-I-R-O-N.
Okay, very good.
And his address?
Su dirección.
Me?
Yeah, donde vive?
141 West Olley.
140 West Olley.
141.
141 West Olley.
Okay.
West Olley.
All right. And you're in favor of granting this application?
A favor de conceder esa solicitud?
Sí.
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Gracias.
That's all we needed.
Todo lo que necesitamos.
All right. Anybody in the audience wish to testify against granting this application?
¿Quiere testificar en contra de conceder la solicitud?
Okay. Seeing none, we thank you. If there's anything else, going once, going twice. All right.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
Yeah, if I wound up misspeaking a little bit before, I was going by solely what I was told by my staff. If there was something included, it was without my knowledge.
All right. Thank you, sir. All right, that concludes this appeal. We'll make a decision at next month's meeting. She need not be here. It will be mailed to her. But she is also welcome to attend if she would like. Thank you. All right, the next matter before us is 1722 North 10th Street, and it's appeal 2017-56. You can grab another chair and bring it up. Okay, Holly, would you swear in our zoning administrator?
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing The whole truth and nothing but the truth to help you God?
Yes, I do. Has notice for this appeal been given?
Yes, it has.
Mr. Price?
Thank you. I'll put some exhibits into the record. Exhibit number one is the notice. Exhibit number two is the proof of publication of the notice. Exhibit number three is proof of posting of the notice. Exhibit number four is the application, including all of its attachments. And exhibit number five is the zoning ordinance of the City of Reading as amended.
Okay, thank you. Would you swear in our interpreter, please?
Do you swear to interpret the English to Spanish and the Spanish to English to the best of your ability to help you God?
Yes, I do.
Okay, are both of these gentlemen going to testify?
He's the engineer, I'm the solicitor.
Okay, then why don't we have both of them sworn in at this time? We'll swear him in first and then we'll do you.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth to help you God?
Sí.
Yes.
Your name, please?
Su nombre?
Mi nombre es Ronald Mercedes.
Ronald Mercedes.
Okay, raise your right hand, please. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth to help you God?
Yes.
Your name?
Ed Nordahl.
Is that all?
Nordahl.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Before we get started, I have one question. Who actually owns this property?
El dueño de la propiedad. ¿Quién es el dueño?
El dueño es Nick, pero yo se la compré. Estamos en proceso del cierre. Yo tengo el agreement, ya mi nombre y todo. Y el cierre va a ser, creo que la próxima semana.
It's still in the name of Nicolaitis. We have a sales agreement. It's moving forward. I believe closing is scheduled for next week.
Okay.
Is there something with that name written on it?
Yeah, I'll go right here.
I think that was sent in with the attack.
I'm sorry, I just need it to start. Sorry, wait.
Mr. Price or Mr. Zaner, are there any issues with that?
I'm sorry.
Are there any issues with this?
I think that's primarily dependent on Mr. Price. Usually an agreement of sale can potentially be legal standing, which I think he would weigh in on.
There is a letter signed by the owner stating that he has permission to seek the zoning approval. I would say that he should supplement the file with the lease purchase agreement, but that would be enough to go further tonight. We don't need it for tonight.
Okay. Basically, if he could send in a copy of the lease purchase agreement as part of the package, it would be appreciated.
Okay, I have a copy in my bag if you need it now.
That would be helpful.
Yeah, that would be helpful. And we can make that a part of the package. Okay.
All right,
thank you. Okay. Why don't we have either the applicant or the engineer tell us exactly what they want to do with this property? Which one of you,
Okay, well, I can speak if you want.
Go ahead.
Okay, lo que quieres.
Hola a todos.
Hello, everybody.
Yo tengo 10 años en el negocio de los camiones y compré esa propiedad para tener los camiones parqueados cerca de mí.
Okay. I've been working in the trucking business now for 10 years, and I purchased that place in order for the trucks to have a parking spot, and it's close to where I live.
Y los planes que tengo es hacer lo parqueo que la ciudad se sienta conforme, cerrarla, ponerle electricidad, ponerle seguridad y hacer todo lo que la ciudad me diga que tenga que hacer.
So I want to do it in a parking lot in such a way that it conforms to all the city regulations and close it in if need be, electricity, security, whatever it needs to take to conform to the city's ordinances.
Okay. A quick question. Since this is going to be an area where there's trucks, what are the hours that this place would operate?
Creo que eso será un lugar de camiones. ¿Cuáles serán las horas que va a estar funcionando el local?
Nosotros los camioneros no tenemos horas, siempre nos van a estar entrando y saliendo.
As truckers, we really don't have a fixed hourly schedule. Truckers come in and leave at any sort of time.
Could I ask, are these trucks all your trucks in your business, or are they going to be trucks that will be able to park there for a fee? Is this what this is about?
¿Todos los camiones son suyos que van a estacionar allí, o serán de otra compañía que van a poder estacionar su camión ahí por un pago?
Yo tengo la gran mayoría mío y tengo algunos de otra compañía que como no se pueden parquear en la ciudad, me han pedido el favor y eso, y le he permitido.
The majority of the trucks are actually mine, yet there are other truckers who have been asking me permission to park there, seeing that there's limited spaces to park trucks in the city. So it'll be part, mostly mine, but part others.
I have a question. Could he assure, pardon me, could he assure this board, the zoning board, that this will not be a repository for junk trucks, trucks that are not operational?
¿Puede usted garantizar a este punto sentado aquí que eso no será un lugar que camiones descompuestos se queden ahí por largo tiempo?
Sí, yo puedo garantizar. De hecho, ahora mismo hay un camión que me le robaron en otro lado. Estaba parqueado, me le robaron el hood, el bumper y ciertas cosas, y ya lo voy a sacar esta semana porque como ya no lo voy a usar, lo voy a sacar, pero eso no es para Junker. Claro que le garantizo que no es para Junker.
Yes, this is not a junk car that I'm going to be running. I could guarantee you that we'll not be keeping unusable trucks stationed on the property. In fact, there was a truck that recently somebody broke in and took the hood and the bumper off of it. It's not currently in a usable state, and I'm going to get it out of the lot this week.
I just wanted to hear that for the record.
I think another concern for that area is noise from diesel trucks, because if they're going to be firing up early in the morning or late at night, and how close are houses to that area? I should know, but I just, you know, I was looking on your drawings here, and I was interested in finding out how close there are any residences to that. Neither the applicant or the engineer maybe could answer that.
Would that be a question you would like to answer?
Sure.
I was out there today, actually. Okay. Before the meeting, I went out. And this is a restaurant here, and this...
Which restaurant?
Williams?
William.
Barbara J. Arner, I believe.
Yeah. It's Williams family. Right.
And then the other one is AF Holding Incorporated. I believe that's a manufacturing. I think the owner is here. I think it's manufacturing.
Okay.
All right. No, I don't.
My casa cerca.
The residence over. Let's see. I didn't see any residences real close by, no. Maybe across the road here.
The applicant is saying there's no no houses really close to the property.
Okay.
How do you get access to the property?
Pardon?
Access.
I have a question about the, I believe it was our attorney said that the zoning follows the property, not the person. In that case, do we have any documentation in here, or in your records, that this property is in fact, or has in fact, been serving as a parking lot prior to Mr. Mercedes taking it over?
No, ahí lo que había era un monte y culebra. No sé si pueden tener bosque. Ahí lo que era un bosque, de hecho, yo cuando cruzaba por ahí, yo llegué a ver hasta culebra, muchos ratones, cucarachas, de todo. Y yo he hecho un cambio grande, grande.
Okay, before I built it, it was kind of brush, woods. Snakes were there. In fact, I've seen snakes, rats on the property. So it was in that condition when I purchased it.
You purchased?
When I rented it, I'm sorry.
Hoy fui yo que lo arreglé.
You rented a piece of land?
Primero lo arreglé.
Un terreno vacío.
Vacío.
Yes, it was empty.
Y yo lo arreglé así como está.
So there's nothing stating, I'm going to keep quiet. Nothing stating that it was ever a parking lot.
Nada que declare que antes servía de parqueo.
Bueno, en lo que yo tengo aquí, yo lo conocí así, como solamente como un monte.
Yeah, when I, as long as I've known that it's been like open land, open land.
I have a question. Question for Mr. Zaner. I read in the code that a parking lot is not appropriate in the MC commercial zone. Is it only appropriate, is it my understanding, if the parking lot is associated with a manufacturing company or business there?
Yes, there's occasionally confusion regarding parking lots, and I would say in the context of zoning, 95%+ of the time, what we're talking about is an accessory use to support a permitted primary use. There's a restaurant building, and then where do the customers park? The parking lot is accessory. It's not standalone, it's not primary. Now, of course, is there potential in very few places of the zoning ordinance for there to be a primary use parking lot? You think of some of the downtown pay parking places is a possible solution. I was a little bit surprised to find out that this kind of a use, I couldn't find a category for it to fit in, even though it is a manufacturing commercial zoning district. I thought there was maybe potential for this kind of a use there, and I was surprised that our staff didn't find something that it fit to. I don't know if, while I have the floor, if this is the time to speak. What I can also let the board know is today there was another zoning appeal dropped off for the place Catty Corner across the street. The people have been in here twice before this year, just in the last couple of months, regarding a boarding house to go in a certain building there in the one corner, and so on and so forth. And they were stating how you have seen that there was some enforcement action that had to be done here, that there was a lot of grading done to the vacant property to make it a parking lot without the contact to us. And that's part of the stuff that led to this all getting here to this point.
And would it need a land development plan?
Oh, absolutely, yes.
Okay, one question I have is, what would be the access road, the main access roads in and out of that facility for these tractor-trailer trucks? Because trucks tend to be getting bigger and bigger.
Off Kutztown Road.
North 10th.
Off North 10th Street.
Off North 10th.
And Burn Street, North 10th and Burn Street. Okay.
All right, thank you. All right, any other members of the board, question?
If this is approved,
go ahead. Jared first.
Oh, I'm sorry, go ahead, Jared.
I have no further questions.
Oh, you didn't, I'm sorry. Okay,
if this is approved, is this parking lot going to have work done to it in order to pave it, line it, that type of thing, that this will be a place where everybody has a place to park in a designated area rather than just kind of randomly parking in there?
Bill, it would have to, as Mr. Zaner said, it would have to go through a full development plan, which would include the right size parking slots, they'll have to do stormwater control, they'll have to do landscaping, all that stuff.
That is correct.
Okay. All right, now, does anybody in the audience have any questions of this applicant? If you do, come up, be sworn in, and just ask your question, and then later on, we will have an opportunity if somebody wants to speak for granting the application, or if somebody wants to speak against granting the application. So anybody with questions at this point? Okay. All right, you want to give us your name and your address, please?
Sure, my name is Mark Ponce. My address is 1007 Summit Road, Temple, PA, 19560.
M-A-R-K?
M-A-R-K.
Okay.
C-E.
Do you own real estate near this property?
I own several real estate throughout the whole county.
Well, do you have any real estate located either next to this property or across the street?
I do not.
Okay, well then you would not have standing to participate in this hearing. You have to have an interest, you have to be a neighboring property owner, something like that, to participate.
Just a citizen that is concerned with what's going on there.
That's not for here, that might be for land development or another private action, but for zoning, you have to have an interest in real estate close to the affected property.
Yeah, I was aware of that.
All right.
All right, yeah, you know, that's not a rule that we've made up, that's what the law says, so thank you. All right, is there anybody that wishes to testify for the granting of the application?
Alguien quiere testificar a favor de esa propiedad?
Two people.
Okay.
Okay, you want to give us your name and address and be sworn in?
My name is Nick Nicolaitis.
Raise your right hand, please. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do.
And your address?
1119 Frederick Boulevard, that's Reading, Pennsylvania, 19605.
And you are the fee simple owner of this property, correct?
Yes, sir.
And you have a lease purchase agreement with Mr. Mercedes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And you're in favor of granting the application?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you.
How long did you own the property for?
7 years.
And what was it when you purchased it?
It was an empty lot. For the past 7 years, we have been using it for our restaurant parking, cars. We park cars there, we park trucks there. You know, not that we've been parking tractor trailers there, but regular cars. You know.
So you own Williams's restaurant, or is that your restaurant?
Yes, it's a family restaurant.
Since you purchased it, what improvements have you made? Have you put stone or anything like that on it?
Yes, we did put stone along the way. That whole area, the parking area, all the gravels.
Is there a curb cut out onto either 10th, North 10th Street or to Burn?
There is also a curb on both entrances.
But is it a curb cut to indicate that there was a designated driveway?
Well, right now, it's not the way it should be.
So you're just driving over a curb?
Well, it's not like you're driving over a curb. There is, it's flat, but it's not the way it should be zoning-wise.
Okay, so there was never a curb cut or highway occupancy permit obtained through either the state or the city, correct?
Okay. Thank you. All right. Is there anybody that would like to speak against granting the application? You come up, you need to be sworn in.
They consider la solicitud.
Raise your right hand, please. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth? I'm sorry, do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth to help you God?
I do.
Your name, please?
George Stuck, the third.
S-T-O-C-K?
S-T-U-C-K.
The third, okay.
I am the president and owner of KF Holding, also Alloy Fabrication.
What fabrication?
Alloy Fabrication.
And you're a neighboring property owner?
Yes.
Okay. All right, go ahead.
Nothing against this gentleman, but this lot has been a problem in the neighborhood. I didn't realize he's the one that's been leasing it, and he indicated that walking into it. There's been water thefts, which I have pictures of here, out of the fire hydrants. To wash the trucks. If you look here, you can see the hose coming out. This has been reported to the police and the mayor's department. And I believe there was an arrest made in that. That's somebody that serviced, that's what these gentlemen use. Trash has built up on the, on this lot. There's been appliances, there's tires, refrigerators that still have the doors on. Yeah, children are playing and dying. I mean, there was so many fires on there, you know, they're a fire hazard and they also can collect mosquitoes. They're not just trucks parking on this lot, but they're also doing truck repair. That orange truck and that white trailer there that you have your picture, those are just storage trailers and that's where they have the equipment that they repair the trucks in. But, and those two trailers, if you look, are not roadworthy. You can see how the sides are rusted out.
Are these just a lot of extra tires just thrown here?
I guess. And there's also, in this picture here, you can see there's a forklift stored on the property. That's for them to use to move freight from truck to truck. I have customers that have come to our company, and these are large companies. They think that that lot's ours, and they're looking, why aren't you guys cleaning up your property? What are we dealing with here?
What is your address, sir?
It is 1700 North 10th Street.
Thank you.
Okay. And there's also a truck parking lot that you can park trucks at, like two blocks away over there behind Giant. It's like between Giant and the Owl, the Humane Society. You know, that's hardly used, so I'm not sure why we need another lot in the neighborhood. You know, that's a lot easier to get in and out of than this property. You know, there's a lot of other stuff that's been going on in the neighborhood. You got Albright that's going to be built, a $20 million facility. You know, the development there of Pittstown Road, you know, that I think Schumann's have done.
Yes, we're familiar with it. We've proved.
You know, which is all good stuff, and we're looking to do some renovations to our property next year. You know, so I don't really feel that this is a good fit for this property. It could be developed for a manufacturing use.
Hey, we have the pictures.
Yeah, here's some more pictures of how the property is kept. I mean, they had so many tires, they actually had some stored them under their personal vehicle.
That's part of the record, too, right?
Anything else you would like to add?
No.
Okay. Now, I'm just going to, because this is all part of the process, does our applicant either confirm or refute some of the things that you've said?
En conformidad lo que ha dicho, quiere refutar algunas cosas que ha dicho.
No estoy conforme con lo que ha dicho porque.
No, I'm not in agreement with what he said.
No es cierto.
There's a lot of things that weren't accurate.
Okay. Would you say that those pictures, and we can show him, let him look at those pictures and we'll see if they accurately reflect what the yard looks like currently.
Well, we cleaned it up right before this process had to start.
Si refleja cómo está la propiedad en la actualidad. Él dijo que ya se le enviaba.
Eso tenía que decirlo desde un principio.
Well, he should have said that we had cleaned the property right from the start.
Now, wait a minute. One person at a time.
The gentleman should have testified that we had cleaned up the property right from the beginning because the property is clean right now.
Okay.
Yo, eso está impecable ahora mismo, y así lo pienso mantener. Me le acerqué a él para decirle de qué manera podemos estar bien como vecino para no afectarle.
So the lot right now is in impeccable shape, and I had even approached this gentleman to say, look, what can we do? We want to be good neighbors. We want to get along together.
Y él fui a la oficina y lo que me dijo, hablamos después del del hearing porque ya él sabía que tenía esto preparado para hacerme un daño.
So I went to his office, but he said, let's not talk now, we'll talk after the hearing, because to me it seems like he just wanted to come in with these pictures to kind of do me harm.
Y cuando uno es nuevo, uno va aprendiendo, como por ejemplo yo sí, como iba poniendo goma, limpié, hace mucho que yo lo limpié, ya estamos hablando de unos 7-8 meses que hizo, está limpio. Limpio, si se pone a ver la foto, como está de sucio, ya eso no está así.
At the beginning, yes, there were problems with the property, but one knows, goes on and learning, and I have cleaned up the property. This is how I want to maintain the property, how it currently is. But it wasn't just like a week ago we cleaned up the property. We had started making arrangements, cleaning it up 7 or 8 months ago.
When did he start putting trucks on that lot?
Cuando comenzó a poner camiones en el solar.
Yo comencé como, no tengo la fecha exacta, pero como un año y medio por ahí. Entre un año y medio, no recuerdo.
I don't know the exact date, but I'm reasonably going to guess about a year and a half.
Un año y medio.
About a year and a half ago.
Pero yo, la razón que estoy aquí, por eso busqué la compañía de ingeniero Lolo, para hacer la cosa bien, para que todo el mundo esté happy conmigo, esté contento y cerrarlo y poner electricidad. So, estoy pagando a la compañía para que me ayude con eso, por la falta de conocimiento.
So, the reason why I'm here is I want to do this project right. That's why I hired an engineer. We want to get this right. We want to protect the property however it needs to be protected. We're willing to enclose the property for the electricity, lighting, whatever needs to be done.
Okay, thank you. Thank you both.
One other thing, I'm not sure if this is a technicality or not, but I did not get any formal letter in the mail notifying us of this hearing.
I believe they post that. They do not send individual letters anymore. Is that correct?
We did get one for the bar.
Pardon?
We did get one for item number 5.
The SOP of the department is for that inspector who's inside to do the case report, in this case, Ms. Hoffman, to follow the rule in the book of notifying all property owners within 100 feet.
And,
I don't know what to tell you.
You know, like I said, it's nothing against him, but I'm just showing you what the past history is of the property has been. So.
Has it been cleaned up, though?
Just like in the last, since late summer, because he had taken right before they started cleaning it up.
Let me ask you a question. If, in fact, he were to be given approval but would have to improve it with paving and go through the land development process, put the proper lighting, the appropriate buffering around the property, would that be something that you would find acceptable or not?
Would be a good start, but I don't understand when we already have a lot 2 blocks away that's not being used, that's already fenced in and already set up to do what they're doing there now, and then probably could be used for, you know, some more manufacturing for what it's, you know, currently used for, or zoned for.
One of the things that you have to understand about zoning is we can't regulate the number of similar type things within an area, you know, it's like grocery stores.
Right.
But we also understand what you're trying to say.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, thank you. All right. If anybody else has anything, if not, Mr. Zahner, please.
I would have a question of the applicant, Mr. Mercedes, if that's how you pronounce the last name. Part of his opening testimony said that about the trucks being majoritively his, something along those lines. When we were investigating who's using this property or whatever, and we did the internet search, we came up with Mr. Mercedes and a business venture name of Safe Transport, I believe it is, and that being assigned to a Westlawn apartment or rental townhouse right across from the Westlawn High School over there.
Okay.
And with that listing, I believe it was like a state incorporation or business venture listing of some kind, it referenced like one vehicle. So I was just wondering if there could be further testimony, if that information is accurate, or what's the discrepancy in that information?
Okay, go ahead.
Okay. Entonces, en la investigación, usted declaró que la mayoría de los camiones que son suyos, ellos han hecho una investigación que dice que hay una corporación o un negocio que es Safe Transport con en West Lawn. Parece que está bajo su nombre, pero ellos solo podrían encontrar un vehículo que está registrado en su nombre. ¿Usted puede aclarar eso?
Sí, yo tengo las registraciones. De hecho, creo que tengo varios. Yo tengo en total, mis dos títulos, yo tengo en total 7.
Okay.
Tengo en total 7. Yo tengo los títulos en mi oficina, los puedo traer y eso.
As far as my trucks go, I do have title of 7 trucks. I have the titles and registrations. Okay, so 7 tractors and 9 trailers that are all with title in my name.
Does that answer your question?
Partially it does. It doesn't quite, and I don't mean to be picky mathematically, I'm just pointing out information. You know, he's referring to 23 tractor trailers and 15 automobiles, so I wouldn't quite consider 7 majority. And I thought why that might be an important factor of you after hearing the neighbor's testimony is just what is the care, custody, control of what's going on there. If it's just his trucks and his employees, you would expect that you could invoke and require a higher level of care, custody, and control. And if it's not that way, this may be the reason why the property had its issues that it had.
Okay. I think it comes, yeah, all right, go ahead. I'll let you take it.
Usted dijo que hubo 23 camiones, quizás con espacio de 5 automóviles, 7 no es la mayoría. La preocupación de él es cuando son suyos, usted tiene control. Cuando son camiones de otro, no hay control. ¿Usted quiere dar comentario?
Sí, yo tengo control porque yo siempre estoy ahí. Yo nunca estoy en la calle. Y yo tengo, sí, por eso dije ahorita que tenía muchos amigos que también se parquean ahí porque no pueden parquearse en la carretera, compañeros de trabajo. Por eso sube a 23 y eso. Pero yo tengo el control porque yo siempre estoy ahí y tengo un empleado ahí en la mañana.
Okay, it's I can maintain control because I spend a lot of my time there. I'm almost always there. I also have a worker who's there from 8 in the morning to 7 at night. And yes, the other trucks that are parking there are friends and co-workers that I know, and I have control by that manner.
Okay, thank you. All right, anything else? All right, seeing nothing, we will issue a decision at next month's meeting. You need not be here, you're welcome to attend, but a decision will be mailed to you. Thank you.
These pictures, I guess.
Yes, if you can hand them back to Mr. Zanger, please.
Thank you.
Holly, do you or do you need a break? Are you guys okay?
I'm all right.
All right, good. All right, the next matter before us is 1155 Elm Street. It's appeal 2017-57. The applicant's present. Please come up here. Would you swear on our zoning officer, please?
That was my question.
Swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth to help you God?
Yes, I do.
Has notice for this appeal been given?
Yes, it has.
Okay, thank you. Mr. Price.
Yes, I'd like to introduce some exhibits into the record. Exhibit number one is the notice. Exhibit number two is proof of posting of the notice. Exhibit number three is proof of publication of the notice. Exhibit number four is the application, including all of its attachments. And exhibit number five is the zoning ordinance of the city of Reading as amended.
Okay, thank you. Would you swear in our interpreter, please?
Do you swear to interpret with the English to Spanish and the Spanish to English to the best of your ability to help you God?
I do.
Raise your right hand, please.
Con la mano derecha.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth to help you God?
Lo juro ante Dios. Yes, I do.
Your name?
Su nombre.
Héctor Manuel Zapata Rosario.
Héctor Manuel Zapata Rosario.
Okay, thank you. Did you swear him in? Okay, do you want to swear in Mr. Herrera?
Raise your right hand. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth to help you God?
Okay, thank you. All right, why don't you tell us a little bit about why you want to change what's going on in this building?
Bueno, yo considero que es una casa bastante grande y tiene potencial para hacer dos unidades. Creo que tengo toda la lo que se requiere para eso.
Well, I believe it's quite a big structure, building, and that two units could easily fit in the that property space.
Mr. Zaner, question for you. I realize you could fit anything anyplace. Would, if he did what he is requesting, would those units comply with the rules and regulations of the city?
With adding the small addition onto the rear, that is the intent of doing that addition, is to bring it up to the minimum 550 square foot threshold for a one bedroom apartment.
So it would be minimum compliant?
Yes.
Thank you. Any other board members have some questions?
Just to clarify it, I think I know the answer. You would still keep the commercial space in the front?
Correcto. Yes, that's correct.
All right.
How long has that? I notice you have a sign up on the window that it's commercial space for rent. So how long has it, is it currently, is it empty and you're looking for somebody new, or how long, what's the story on that lower building? And I'll remind him, I'm only asking because it depends, it would impact the parking spaces on what would be there.
Estoy preguntando por el impacto quizás que tuviera en los lugares de estacionamiento en los alrededores.
Sí. Bueno, la casa estuvo vacía por un tiempo. Yo la compré hace 3 o 4 meses, algo así. Antes era comercial, o sea, siempre ha sido comercial. Y siempre funcionaba bien, hasta donde tengo entendido. Habían varios negocios ahí, hubieron varios negocios ahí.
So I bought the property some time ago, maybe 3 or 4 months ago, and as far as I know, there were always commercial ventures that were there that always seemed to work well and had no problems.
Is it, it's empty now?
Yes,
it's empty.
Okay, that's okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Anybody else?
I have no questions.
Could you explain a little bit about the parking? Where would these cars be parked?
Explícanos un poco en cuanto a estacionamiento. ¿Dónde estacionaría los vehículos?
Bueno, yo tengo 3 parqueos disponibles para las unidades. Lo que se trata de un del local comercial es algo pequeño. Como ustedes tienen, como tenemos entendido, por ejemplo, aquí en la ciudad de Reading, es muy raro el negocio pequeño que tiene un parqueo. Yo tengo 3 parqueos disponibles para lo que vaya a hacer ahí, si me lo permiten.
Okay, so I do have 3 parking spaces that would be available. They can be used for the living units or the local business. The local business commercial part would be something small. And I've seen in the city, there's a lot of commercial buildings that don't even have parking. I have three parking spaces for the building complex.
Off-street parking?
Okay, so we got us fuera de la calle?
Where, could we see where those parking spaces are?
Yes, off-street parking.
Right here.
Señala.
Okay.
I have two here and one there.
Mr. Zaner, if I read this correctly, the information we had from the inspectors.
De los inspectores.
Those parking spaces are probably unusable because they're not the right size. Is that a correct statement, or did I read that wrong?
Yes, I would expound a little bit on the explanation to this extent. The two garage bay doors that are facing North Wall Street are very typical everyday overhead garage doors that you might have at your home. The two-story garage is actually built on land that is sloping rapidly away from 12th Street. And so it is actually, I would want to say like bi-level or split-level design, in that the two bay doors that do face 12th Street only go about halfway back in the building. What the plan preparer has down is something along the lines of 14 feet 8 inches, rounding off closer toward 15 feet. And the information that can be conveyed to this board is that our zoning ordinance depth for a parking space is 18 feet. There just aren't garages built at only a 14 foot 8 inch depth. You know, nowadays you just can't fit a modern car in there. And it was noticed that these bays aren't currently occupied by automobiles and instead are personal storage. Not that that's necessarily that unusual, unless it's indicative of the shortness really doesn't suit parking a car in there very well. And then further, the inland garage bay is going down the slope further, and one has to go down the narrow alley. And that does not have the typical overhead garage door as the ones you would see in any photos or representation in the submission, but has a much smaller, older style door. And with that alley width being slightly less than 10 feet, for a 90 degree parking situation and a smaller than normal garage door access, it would seem that would be actually unusable. When you think of our 90 degree parking regulation requires 22 feet to get in and out of a 90 degree parking space, this is like 9 feet 11 inches.
Okay. Thank you very much. Appreciate that. All right, any other questions from anybody on the board? Mr. Zaner, do you have anything?
I have nothing new.
Okay. Mr. Price?
Nothing.
Okay.
Mr. Herrera to testify.
Yeah. Mr. Herrera, why don't you walk us through what you're planning to do? I mean, I know we have your plans in front of us, but just kind of talk us through this.
Needs to be sworn in.
Yeah, he was.
Oh, did?
Okay. Yeah.
Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
This drawing shows the existing conditions of the two levels of the property. This being the front of the property where the commercial space is located. This blue area represents the rear of the first floor. These elements that are on hidden lines are the items
I'm
that...
I'm sorry, missed
this. The walls represented with hidden lines on this space are the...